In part one of our lesson on half-angle identities, we'll derive the half-angle identities for sine, cosine, and tangent. You probably remember that the double angle for cosine has three different versions. We're going to start off with this one, where cosine of 2x is equal to 1 minus 2 sine squared of x. And we are going to solve this for sine of x. Now, I like to have my variables be positive, so I'm going to take the negative 2 sine squared of x and bring it over to the left-hand side so that it becomes positive 2 sine squared x. The 1 will stay there, and we're going to bring the cosine of 2x over to the right-hand side, so it will become minus cosine 2x. Divide the left-hand side and the right-hand side by 2, and we get sine squared of x is equal to 1 minus cosine of 2x divided by 2. By the square roots property, we get that sine of x will have to be plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of 2x divided by 2. And now we're going to do a substitution where we let a equal 2x, which then means that a over 2 will equal x. And we're going to make these substitutions into the equation that we have. So then that means the left-hand side is going to become sine of a over 2 equals, the right-hand side becomes plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of a divided by 2. Because remember, the 2x becomes a, and the x becomes a over 2. And this is what's known as the half-angle identity for sine. Next, we will start with the double angle for cosine, where cosine of 2x is equal to 2 cosine squared of x minus 1, and this time we will solve it for cosine x. So the first thing we will do is add 1 to both sides, and now we have 2 cosine squared of x is equal to 1 plus cosine 2x. Dividing both sides by 2, we get cosine squared of x is equal to 1 plus cosine 2x over 2. Now we apply the square roots property, and we get that cosine of x will equal plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine 2x over 2. Similarly, for what we just did for the half angle identity for sine, we will let a equal 2x so that a over 2 will substitute in for x. So on the left-hand side, it will become cosine of a over 2, because that a over 2 is going in for the x, equals plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine of a, because remember the a is going in for 2x, over 2. And this is the half angle identity for cosine. Next, we will derive the half angle identity for tangent. And tangent of a over 2 will equal sine of a over 2 divided by cosine of a over 2. Now we can substitute in the identities that we just derived. We know that sine of a over 2 will be plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of a over 2, and cosine of a over 2 is plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine of a divided by 2. This turns into plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine a over 2 times plus or minus the square root of 2 over 1 plus cosine of a, because remember, dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by its reciprocal. The 2's are going to cancel out, and we will end up with plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of a divided by 1 plus cosine of a. So this will be the half angle identity for tangent. Next, we will find two alternate forms of the half angle for tangent. So we will start out by saying that tangent of a over 2 is equal to sine of a over 2 divided by cosine of a over 2. So we're starting out in exactly the same way we did just a minute ago. But now we will take a very different path. We are going to multiply this rational expression by 1 in the form of 2 cosine of a over 2 over itself. Now, this is not something I would have expected you to come up with all on your own. Your job right now is to understand how this proof is working and to grow mathematically through that proof. So the numerator becomes 2 sine of a over 2 cosine of a over 2, and the denominator is 2 cosine squared of a over 2. Now, in the denominator, we are going to add 0. So the way we're going to do that is we're going to say minus 1 plus 1 in the denominator. So remember, this is just adding 0. And then we will associate the first two terms together. Now, what happens next is, hopefully you recognize that this numerator is the double angle for sine. So if we have 2 sine of something cosine of something, that becomes sine of 2 times the something. And in this case, that is a over 2. Now in the denominator, the reason that we added 0 by doing minus 1 plus 1 was because we recognize this now as being the double angle for cosine, and we know that 2 cosine squared of something minus 1 is equal to cosine of 2 times the something, which is a over 2. And then we have to add 1. This turns into the sine of A divided by the cosine of A plus 1. So we have an identity now that tangent of A over 2 is equal to sine of A over, and it's common to write this denominator as 1 plus cosine of A. So this is the first alternate form of the half-angle identity for tangent. To get the second alternate form for the half-angle identity for tangent, we will begin by writing that tangent of A over 2 is equal to the identity that we just derived, sine of A divided by 1 plus cosine of A. Once again, we're going to multiply by 1. This time, it's going to be in the form 1 minus cosine of A over itself. Now, the numerator I'm going to leave in factored form. So, sine of A times 1 minus cosine of A. In the denominator, we have the familiar algebra form, a plus b times a minus b, which we know is a squared minus b squared. So this is going to be 1 minus the cosine squared of a. Now this is equal to the sine of a times 1 minus cosine of A, and we know we can make a Pythagorean identity substitution here to say that 1 minus cosine squared of A is going to be replaced with sine squared of A. Now the sine of A up here will cancel one of the sine squareds down here, and we will be left with 1 minus cosine of A over sine of A. And this is the second alternate form for the half angle for tangent. So let's go ahead and fill in the summary box for the half-angle identities. It turned out that tangent has three different identities. The first one was plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of A divided by 1 plus cosine of A. And it's important to notice that this entire rational expression is underneath the radical. Some students make the mistake where they only put the numerator under the radical, but it's the whole entire thing that is under the radical. And this one has a plus and minus sign associated with it. Then there were two alternate forms. Tangent of A over 2 is also equal to sine of A divided by 1 plus cosine of A. And the third one is 1 minus cosine of A divided by sine of A. Now, all three of these will work, and we will talk about the strategies to help you decide which one to use. Now, the sine of A over 2 only has one, and it is plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of A divided by 2. Cosine of A over 2 is plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine of A divided by 2. And again, just a reminder, in both of these formulas, the entire rational expression is underneath the radical, not just the numerator. So these 2's in the denominator are under the radical, and both of these have a plus and minus sign that has to be included. And as always, I strongly suggest that you write these down 2 or 3 times a day, and particularly make sure you write them down right before you go to use them in each homework problem. It'll help you memorize them quickly.